Hey, this is Asaf Levavi from LickNRiff.com, and it's time for another viewer request. And in this video, I'm going to teach you a fingerstyle arrangement I've made especially for you guys and girls of Billie Jean, the huge Michael Jackson hit. First, I'm going to play it for you so you can see and hear how it goes, and then we're going to break it down lick by lick with tabs on the screen. I'm going to show you exactly how it's done, note by note, lick by lick, finger position by finger position. But first, it goes like this. If you've noticed, this is in an open tuning. Okay, you tune your guitar to an open tuning. Now, this is tuned to G minor, open G minor tuning. Now, how do you tune your guitar to open G minor? It's actually very simple. You tune the E bass down to D. Okay, from E to D, a whole step, down to D. You tune your A string down to G, okay, a whole step as well, so you actually have D, G, D, G, okay? So, again, you tune the E bass down to D, you tune the A bass down to G. You tune the E string down to D as well, okay, so you actually have three D strings. You have D on the sixth string, D on the fourth string, the usual D string, and you have D on the E string as well, on the first string. Now the only thing remaining is to tune the B string down a half step to B flat. Okay, because if it stays on B, it's a G major chord, and if it's B flat, it's G minor. So you tune your B string, your second string, down a half step to B flat, so you have D, G, D, G, B flat, D. Okay, so open G minor. Now, the interesting thing about the open G or G minor tunings is that your G bass is on the A string. It's on the fifth string, so you only use the sixth string as kind of a lick generator, and that's what we're gonna do in the intro. So open tunings usually make everything a lot easier because you just have to bar a fret for a different chord, or bar a fret and just add one more finger if you want to change the quality of the chord. And that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna play G minor, okay, just open strings, G minor. We're gonna bar the fifth fret and play C minor, okay, that's it, just one finger, okay, on five, C minor. We're gonna bar the seventh fret, and we're gonna raise the second string back half a step for a major chord, so we're gonna add a finger on eight on the second string. and this is D major, because without the finger it's D minor. So we just raise this back to a major chord, and we're gonna play the same chord up one fret on 8 and 9 on the second string, and we're gonna play E flat, A flat major. That's the four chords we're gonna use for this song. Open strings, bar on 5, bar on 7 with the raised second string, and bar on 8 with the raised second string. That's it. Okay, four chords. Okay? Now, we're also going to bar the 10th fret for a second there, but technically we're going to use it as a C minor chord. We're going to do this. Okay, and our bass note is going to be on the 6th string, so it's still going to be C. Okay, so it's just for harmonic purposes. We're not changing a chord there. Alright, so that's what we're going to use. All the rest is either going to be picking different strings inside the chords, or just adding a finger and taking it back off. That's it, just like something like this. So let's begin with the intro. Now the intro is probably the most complex lick of this entire arrangement, because there's a lot going on there. The bass lick and the harmony lick. So we're playing both the bass lick, okay, and the lick. So the intro is the most complicated part of this arrangement. All the rest is fairly easy. So let's start with the intro. We'll get the most complicated part done, and then it'll be smooth sailing. So the intro goes like this. Okay, that's the intro lick. Let me play it a bit slower. That's basically what's going on. So you begin by playing strings 3, 4, and 5, and then you play 0 and 3 on the 6th string. Okay, so it's, and then you play, you bar the 2nd fret up to the 4th string, okay, and you play 2 and 2 on strings 3 and 4. Okay, so it's, and then you play open 5th string, and then 0-3-0 on the 6th string. Okay, so the bass lick is this. Okay, 5th string, 0-3-0 on the 6th string. Okay, so that's the first of two licks, which are practically the same. Except for this. So, this. Open strings. Open 3rd, 4th, and 5th strings. Then 0, 3 on the bass. Then 2 and 2 on strings 3 and 4. Then open 5th string. 0, 3, 0 on the 6th string. Okay. Now, the picking pattern of the second lick is exactly the same, only instead of 0 and 2 on strings 3 and 4, you play 3 and 2. Okay, so the only thing that changes is this. Okay, you started with this on the first lick, open strings 3, 4, and 5. This time you play 3 and 3 on the 3rd and 4th strings. That's it, you bar both strings, strings 3 and 4, and you play 3, 4, and 5, strings 3, 4, and 5, with the open 5th string. So it's this. Okay, 3 on the 3rd string, 3 on the 4th string, open 5th string. That's the only difference. The rest of the lick is exactly the same. So, okay, exactly the same. So 3, 3, and 0 on strings 3, 4, and 5. 0 and 3 on the bass. 2 and 2 on strings 3 and 4. Open 5th string. 0, 3, 0 on the 6th string. Okay? I hope you got it. Now let's play it slowly again. Open. 0, 3. 2 and 2. 0, 0, 3, 0. Then 3 and 3 with the open A string. 0, 3. 2 and 2. 0. Open bass. 3. Open again. Okay? As usual, explaining it is a lot more complicated than playing it. Okay? Just play it slowly. Okay? Until you're comfortable with this. That's the intro. That's it. That's the most complicated part. Congratulations. Now, we're gonna have some fun. The way we're gonna learn this is we're gonna talk about the bass note, we're gonna talk about the melody, and then I'm gonna give you options as for when you can play the chord. Because basically you can play the chord anytime you like, as long as the bass note is at the beginning of the bar, and that's it. You just play the bass note, and then you can either play the melody or add more bass notes or play the chord along with it, just open strings. Okay? That's your options, basically. So we just covered the options. We're gonna talk a lot more about it after we learn it. I just wanted to show you a couple of ways you can practice this. So, the verse. The verse begins with what I just played. So you play the open A string, okay, which is an open G bass right now. So the chord is still G minor. So you play the bass, and then the melody is this. Okay? It's the open E string 4 times, then on the B string 2, 0, 2, 0, then open E string again. Okay? I don't think that this is too hard. Okay, so I won't repeat it. It's very simple. Okay? Now, again, you can add bass notes if you want, and you can add the chord. You can play the rest of the strings anytime you like. Okay? That's what you can do with it. Now, if you want to complicate things a little bit farther, you can add this. Okay? And play this on the bass along with the open E string. So you can play bass, then open E string, then open E string with 3 on the bass, then open string with open D bass, then open string with the G bass again. So you get, right? You can do it, you can choose not to, both versions work. Right? If you want to add a bass line to this, and then it will sound like this. So that's the complicated version. And then it's just the next line is just, OK? okay? Or if you wanna get really, really specific, it's 0-2-0 on the B string and then open E string, okay? And again, you add the bass note whenever you want, okay? Either along with 2 or all the way through. And again, you can add the chord. Okay? You can play the chord all the way through. Or just emphasize by adding 1 chord. Okay, I just added 2, but never mind. You get the point. So, the first phrase is this. And then... the next one is the same as the first. I don't have to explain it, right? Pretty simple. So, if you look at it one way, it's just playing the same thing 3 times with the second time abbreviated. So, open E string, 2 and 0 on the B string. That's all the notes we're using. So, that's it. And then again. Okay? And then you play this. Okay? 2-0 on the B string and then 2-0 on the G string. Again, G bass anytime you like. Now, I suggest you don't play the G bass when you play the open G string because you have to change a chord right now. So the next bass note would be C. So, okay, and then you bar the 5th fret and you play this. Okay? What I play here is this. I play the 5th string and then the chord. Okay, and I play the chord on strings 2, 3, and 4, but you can play them on 1, 2, and 3. Okay? There's no rule for which strings you use to play the chord because the entire bar is the chord, so you can choose any strings you want as your chord. Again, you make your own arrangement of this. I only teach you the melody and the options. I give you all the options I can think of, and you make your own arrangement of this. Okay, I'm not gonna give you all the answers. So, okay, this is what I play. I play the bass, okay, on the 5th string, then the chord, then 8-5 on the D bass, and then I play the chord again, okay? And then I play the C bass again anytime I want with the next lick. So it's... okay? Now, what I do is I play the bass first, and then I play the lick, then I play the bass again, then I play the lick, then I play the bass, then I play the lick. So I alternate between the bass and the lick. Something like this. So the lick is just 5 hammer-on to 7 on the D string. Okay, and then 5 again. So it's 5 hammer-on to 7, 5. And then you play it again. And then you hammer on again, but then you play open G string as the last note. So it's 5-7-5, 5-7-5, 5-7 open G string. Because we're back to G minor, okay? So you play, okay, and you can harmonize with the chord. Okay, again, that's your choice. Okay, and add bass notes whenever you like. Or. Okay, you can add 2 bass notes. Again, you have choices. Do what feels right to you. So the C minor lick goes like this. with the G string, you can harmonize with the D string or any other note. Okay? It works. Anything you play works. Open tuning makes everything a lot easier. So, in case you're still a bit confused, let me play it slowly. Bass chord. 8-5 on the bass, on the D bass, the lower bass. And then chord again. And then bass anytime you want. 5-7-5 on the D string. And it's... Okay? Open G string at the end. 5-7-5, 5-7-5, 5-7, open G string. And hammer on the 5-7. So, for now, what we have is this. I'm not used to playing it slowly because it's a bit more confusing for me to play it slower, but I think it was a nice demonstration. So again, 0-2-0-2-0, open E string again, then 0-2-0 on the B string, E string again, then 2-0 on the B string, 2-0 on the G string. Bar 5, bass chord, 8-5 on the D bass, chord again, 5-7-5, 5-7-5, 5-7, open G string. Then you can play a little bit of the intro again, if you want. If not, just play G minor. Okay, again, in any way you want. And then play this again. Okay, or... Okay, which is kind of a variation on the last lick of the G minor chord. But first... no, actually, the variation just adds the open G string at the beginning. So it's open G string, open B string, and then 2-0 on the B string, 2-0 on the G string. So... So the variation just adds an open G string at the beginning and an open B string. So, okay, you play an open G string and an open B string, the B flat string, an open G string and an open B string, and then 2-0 on the B string, 2-0 on the G string, and you play this again. So, as I said, you can add a bit of the intro there, which is this. Can play the bass line, okay? Just bass chord, then 3-0 on the bass, and then 0-3-0 on the bass again, and then the second lick of the intro, okay? Or you can play an open G minor chord. Okay, and then... Okay? It's up to you. You can either, again, play a part of the intro and then add... Or just play an open G minor and play this. Again. Let me try and demonstrate what I mean. Open G minor. Okay, just the open chord. If we add the intro, it's this. Okay. Now I got it. You play the entire intro, okay, from the start. And then the very, very last note, instead of this, instead of 2 and 2 on strings 3 and 4, you play the variation. Okay? Instead of that. So. Got it? It's 0, 2, 3, and then instead of 2 again, you play. Play the G string and B string, and then 2-0 on the B string, 2-0 on the G string, and you play this again. And then you can play this again. Okay? The whole intro. So, let's play the entire verse so you can make sense out of everything I just tried to explain. Successfully, hopefully. Let's play it. Actually, let's play it from the start. Intro. 3, 2, 0, 2, 3, 2. The lick again. 2, 0, 2, 0. Then you play the verse again, okay? And after the intro, you play this, the pre-chorus. The pre-chorus goes like this. It's E flat, then G minor again, then E flat again, G minor again. Then E flat again, same first line. Then E flat again. Then down one fret to D. And then the chorus. So the pre-chorus begins on E flat. You bar the 8th fret. Right, and add a finger on the 9th fret of the 2nd string. So it's E flat major, not minor, with just one finger. Okay, and what you play is this. It's all the chord. Okay, so the melody, the very basic melody, is the 2nd string 5 times, and then the E string. Okay? The B string on 9, the E string on 8. So, now, as usual, you can add a bass anywhere you want. Okay? Even though I don't recommend adding that much bass, just add 1 or 2 bass notes. Okay? You can harmonize with the chord any way you want. 1 string, 2 strings, the entire chord. Okay, that was exaggerated for demonstration purposes. So again, you can harmonize any way you want, but that's the line. And then 9 again on the B string, right before you move on to the G minor. Then you play this. Okay? It's 8 pull off to 5 and 5 again on the E string. Okay? 8, 5, 5. Then 3, 5 pull off to 3, open E string. So it's 8-5-5-3-5-3-0. Now, you have to add the chord here. So you add it on 8. Then you add it on 5. Okay? You add it right before every pull off. So pull off with chord, pull off with chord. That's the basic thing that I add. Again, you can only add the bass note. You can add the chord all the time. But the basic addition is on 8 and on 5. Okay? You can add more chords as you wish. You can harmonize with the chord with strings 2 and 3 open all the way. Okay, it works. Just don't forget to add the bass notes. Bass for emphasis. So, that's the second lick. So, it's this. And then you play the open E string again. Then the first ending. The first ending is on E flat again, and you play the same thing again. Okay? Second string, 5 times, E string. Okay? Then open G minor chord with 5 on the E string. Okay? And then again, you have a choice. You have a bar of G minor, or you can play the intro again if you're daring enough to just get it in there, or you can play the bass along with the chord. Let me give you some examples. Okay, like this, just the bass line, or the intro. Okay, but in my opinion, it doesn't fit there, so I don't play it. I just play the bass notes if I want to. So if I don't, then I just play the chord. It works as well. And then, okay, then you play the first line again. Okay, exactly the same. Okay, and then the second ending starts the same way. No, actually, it does start the same way. Only this time you don't play the E string. You only play the B string. Okay, so you play it do 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 5 times and then twice more. Do 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 do. Okay? And again, you add the bass on 8 on the A string anytime you want. Okay. And then you take this down one fret to 7 and 8, and you do this. You play the chord, I play strings 2, 3, and 5, and then I play the B string again twice, and then I add 9 on the B string. So it's, again, you can harmonize, and then the E string on 7, it's the bar, and then pull off from 8 to 7 on the E string, and then you take the chord off and you play 9 on the B string. Now you take everything off because you're gonna start the chorus in a millisecond and you want to play the bass, but you want to keep this note ringing, and that's why you take the chord off and you play 9 on the B string. So it's 8 8 8 9 on the B string, E string on 7, pull off on 8 from 8 to 7 on the E string, 9 on the B string, take the chord off, and then when you play the bass of the next G minor chord, this note keeps ringing. Okay, so they melt into each other. So, the second line was this. Okay. then the chorus. So, the pre-chorus again. First ending, line again, second ending, seven, okay, that's the pre-chorus. Now for the chorus itself. The chorus itself goes like this. It's almost entirely on an open G minor chord. So and then you bar 5 for C minor chord, and then a small lick on 10, then 5 again, then you're back to G minor. And then I just added the synthesized violin lick. Okay, you don't have to do it. And then it's back. And then on 5 again. So, let's start. It's G minor all the way. So let's just learn the melody so you'll see how easy it is. It's just the bass, then 5-5-3-0 on the E string, then 5-5-3-0 again, slightly different rhythm, then it's 5-5-5-3-0, okay, instead of 5-5-3-0, it's 5-5-5-3-0, okay, huge change, and then it's 5-8, then it's 10-8-7, and then you bar the 5th fret. But before we do that, let's just play it. Okay, again, you can add any chord you want anytime you want. You can harmonize with the chord all the time. You can just harmonize a couple of notes. Okay, everything works. So, 5-5-3-0, 5-5-3-0. 5-5-5-3-0, 5-8-10-8-5. Okay? Okay, you can slide to 8, to 10. You can slide from 8 to 10. Okay? Again, you've got tons of choices here. So, bar the 5th fret. Okay? And just play the chord. I play strings 1, 2, 3, and 5 because the melody note is on the E string. Okay, so it's important that you play that. Now, again, you've got a choice. You can just play the chord. Okay, and then play 5, 5 at the end there. That's important. Okay, because it's but the. Okay, high voice. So, chord 5-5, or you can play 8 and 5 on the D bass again as a bass lick. So it's okay. You can play the chord and then play 8-5, and then the chord again, and then 5-5. Okay, that's a choice. So, or and then you bar 10, and this time you play the E bass, okay, the E string, which is a D bass right now, okay, but let's not get too technical about it, and you play 12 and 10 on the E string, and you play the chord along with it, okay, for emphasis. Now, this keeps it a C minor chord, so, okay, so don't play this. It's not a chord change. You don't play the A string. You play the E bass. So, and then you go quickly back to barring five and you play, okay? You play strings one and two along with the bass, okay? And open E string. So it's, and then you play the G minor chord. And if you want, okay, you play the G minor chord for a whole bar, or if you want to play the synthesized violin line, you play this. Okay, which is double pull off from 8 to 7 to 5 on the E string, and then a hammer on to 7 on the B string. Okay, it's a hammer on out of nowhere because we don't pick the B string. It's just, okay, it's 8, pull off, hammer on to 7 on the B string. You don't pick again. Okay, it's a quick lick. Okay, so it's, and then 0 hammer on to 3 on the E string, and then open E string again. So it's, okay, that's the line. Okay, and you don't have time to rest if you play this, because right away you have to play, okay, you play 5, 8, 10, 8, 7, C minor chord again. So you repeat the end of the chorus. So what you get is this. Again. Got it? Violin lick. Then you get one bass and you play 5, 8, 10, 8, 7, C minor chord again. Again. And then, and then you play the intro again, and you loop everything, and you play everything again, and then right before we learn the solo that ends this arrangement, let's play the chorus again. So 5 5 3 0 5 5 3 0 5 5 5 3 0 5 8 10 8 7 5 C minor 5 5 12 10 5 5 on E and B open G minor violin lick and then 5 8 10 8 7 5 again 12 10 E string B string on 5 open G minor again. Intro. So it's fairly easy, but it gives you no time to rest. So practice this slowly. Now I'm gonna play it, I'm gonna play the chorus and then we're gonna learn the solo. So you can slide into five if you want, again, embellish it. But I had no time to rest. I had to play the intro. So that's the chorus. Now for the solo. The solo is pretty simple. It's just, why am I having trouble with this? And then it's the same notes, only on the C minor chord. And on G again, G minor. So on G minor, it's on the B string, it's 2 hammer on to 4, 2 0. Okay, 2 hammer on to 4, 2 0. then to hammer on to 4 again. Okay? That's it. And you just repeat it. Four times. And then you bar 5. And the solo is on the G string. You hammer on 5 to 7 and then 5 again. And then 8 on the D string. And you hammer on 5 to 7 again on the G string. Okay, so it's 5, 7, 5, 8 on the D string, 5 to 7 on the G string again. And what I pick here are just strings 3, 4, and 5. Okay? Just for the chords purposes. So, but you can play the chord. Okay, but in my opinion, it just confuses the ear. It's a bit cluttered. Okay, it's a whole different chord, a whole different harmony altogether. Okay, so I prefer to just play strings 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and then again, you can play the chorus, you can play the verse and the chorus, you can go back to the intro and finish on G minor or however you like. Any finishing touch you like, or you can start soloing. Okay, you can start a solo, start improvising on all those notes that we played, or just finish it. Again, your choice, your arrangement, and you're done. Before you go practice this, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I've got a ton of lessons right here already, all for free. And go download the tab from the website. It's also for free. Everything is for free here on LickNRiff. But if you want to give something back, there's a donation button right there on the website. You can give anything you want. I'd be very grateful for any donation whatsoever. And everything, of course, goes right back into LickNRiff, into making time to make these arrangements, make the lessons, film them, edit them, practicing this as well. It all takes time and work. And I'd appreciate any help in producing these videos. So thank you very much in advance for any donation you choose to make. Now, you go practice this. Go get it under your fingers. Have fun with this. Make your own arrangement. Let me know how it goes. And spread the word. Share this lesson with your friends, your enemies, your family, your pets, your imaginary friends, your grandparents, your uncles, your aunts, your cousins. Anyone who might want to learn this. Now you go, I'll let you go, I'll stop talking, I'll go drink something or eat something or just rest. And you go play. Thank you very much for watching, I'll see you in the next lesson.